Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Hida Sharif. My main topic is geriatric dementias and my subtopic is dementia with the Lewy bodies. Now, what is the dementia? That it is basically a set of symptoms that includes a decline in the mental abilities. हम उन symptoms के set को कहेंगे जिसकी वजह से आपकी जो normal activity या जो mental activity होती है, ability होती है काम करने की, वो कम हो जाती है. As my main topic is dementias because of the Lewy body, that what is this? It is clinically defines that presence of dementia. Dementia की presence तो होगी, but predominantly उसमें क्या चीज़ मौजूद होगी जिसकी वजह से वो दूसरी dementias को differentiate कर रहा है, separate कर रहा है, that it includes the hallucinations and the delusions. There is a fluctuation in the alertness and the gait balance disorder. And it accounts, यानी degenerative dementias जो होते हैं उसमें ये 20-30% आपका जो Lewy body dementias responsible होते हैं. Now, what is the difference between the degenerative and the non-progressive? There is a difference between the degenerative and non-progressive dementias is that in the degenerative there is a progressively decline, यानी कि वो progressively वहाँ पे declination होगी, decrease होगा, treatable but not the curable, at most common in the Alzheimer's, that is 50%, and in the case of LBD, that is Lewy body dementia, it is account for 15-20%. While the non-progressive, there is abrupt decline, that is acute decline, and often reversible, and most common in the vascular dementia, that is 15-20%. Now remember this, Lewy body dementia is not the Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is separate from the Lewy body dementia. In this case, brain autopsy. In the case of Alzheimer's disease, there is a plaques and tangles. But in the case of Lewy body dementia, in the case of brain autopsy, we obtain the Lewy bodies. Action, in the case of Alzheimer's disease, there is weakens then strangles. Yeah, but in the case of LBD, there is extraction of the acetylcholine from the nerve cells. We know that acetylcholine is very important for the brain functioning. So there is an extract the acetylcholine from the nerve cells. As a result, in the case of Alzheimer's disease, there is a generally decline. But in the case of Lewy body dementia, there is a fluctuating symptoms are basically obtained. While in the case of brain cells, there is in case of Alzheimer's disease, brain cells are killed or finished or death indiscriminately. But the Lewy body dementia kills the brain cells selectively. And in the case of lethal Alzheimer's disease, as we know that it is a very lethal disease, but in the case of Lewy body dementia, it is not necessary that it will be lethal. Now, first we know now what is the Lewy bodies. In the Lewy bodies, these are basically a tiny abnormal protein containing the inclusion bodies and mostly found in the people with the Parkinson's disease. It was discovered in 1912 and studies going on to distinguish between the DLB and the PPD, means the Lewy body dementia and the Parkinson's disease dementia. Many patients display the extra pyramidal signs without showing Parkinson's disease, means it is not necessary that jinko Lewy body dementia ho unko Parkinson's disease ho. Sometimes aise hota hai ki Parkinson's disease hoti hai lekin uske symptoms show nahi ho rahe honge, aur kisi mein symptoms show ho rahe hote hain lekin unko zaruri nahi ki wo cheez ho. And the main role is the alpha synuclein, which is present in both, in the case of Parkinson's disease dementia and the case of Lewy body dementia. Alpha synuclein is basically a type of protein which basically brain cells mein aapke maujood hoga, or 1% of the brain cells aapke wo banata hai. And it basically, in the case of Lewy body dementia, there is more aggregates of alpha synuclein as compared to the Parkinson's dementia. Now, as you see that Lewy bodies under the microscope, that is red color, the group of cells, aggregate of cells indicating the Lewy body, and the right one you have seeing the gray color picture is basically the Lewy body and the red color is basically the nucleus. Now, what will be the diagnosis of the Lewy body dementia? First, we need to done with the brain autopsy. Brain autopsy is very important in the case of the diagnosis of the dementia. There are basically two types of brain scans and which are used in the research in the US. Now, one is the PET, that is the positron emission tomography, and number two is the SPECT, that is single photon emission computed tomography. First, we must know that there must be a dementia, must be present for both, like in the case of LBD or in the case of PDD. LBD is the Lewy body dementia and PDD is the Parkinson's dementia. So there must be a dementia. Then we have two types of features, that is number one is the core features. It includes the fluctuating cognition, recurrent visual hallucinations and the Parkinsonism. While in the case of suggestive features, there must be a REM, sleep behavior disorder, that is RBD. REM, sleep behavior disorder, is basically a suggestive features, and there's abnormality is obtained, abnormal result is obtained on the brain scans, that is PET and the SPECT. Probability is that dementia basically obtained along with the two core features, either with the fluctuating cognition or either any factor, or it must be a one core factor and one selective features. And second possibility is that the dementia along with the one core features or the another with the suggestive features. Now, what is the indicative biomarkers? It indicates that there is a decrease in the dopamine transporter uptake in the basic ganglia in the, according to our brain scans. There is basically a five steps. Number one is the Lewy body dementia. There must be a dementia. Then we have the symptoms. Then we have the management and the treatment. And there's a LVDA and other resources and the caregiver care. That is the management. Now, what are the symptoms of the Lewy body dementia? That there is an autonomic problems, that basically a frequent fall, ki wo baar baar gir jayega. There is a urinary system problems, there is difficulty in the swallowing, thinking and reasoning, confusions, slowness, gait imbalance and other features. Then pharmacological management, and how we treat or how we manage the Lewy body dementia. Number first drug of choice will be the cholinesterase inhibitors, that is the rivastigmin and donepezil. Second one is the anti-Parkinson's agent, that cinemate, that either it is because of the Parkinson's agents or other symptoms is obtained, then we will give the anti-Parkinson's agent. Then atypical antipsychotics for the different type of symptoms to cure the symptom, that is olanzapine, and the antidepressant. If there is depression or anxiety is observed in the patients, then we will give the antidepressant which include the Remeron. Now, we should know that also along with the pharmacological management, we have also treat them their behavior, because we know that in the case of dementia, there are also behavioral changes. So we should avoid the stimulating conditions, and a soothing environment is provided in his or her room, and he or she should move and speak slowly, and we should not challenge the delusions or hallucinations, and need to distract them with interesting things. Unko unke paas shauk ho ya interesting, like reading a book or koi cheez ho, unko distract karne ki koshish karni chahiye. We should not stimulate them so that otherwise they will become the hypersensitive, and the management is very difficult. Then we have a case study in which there is an old woman, that is 72 year old woman, who was diagnosed previously around 6 months ago with a mild cognitive impairment, and from the last 1 year there is an increased forgetfulness and the confused nature. So her family decided around 3 months ago, her family decided that they should move her with them so that she should not feel alone. But what her son observed, that there is basically that she seems space out times at several times, and there is basically increased forgetfulness and need assistance in the daily tasks too. Her daughter now reported that she has unsteady on her feet at times and fallen twice. At the physician visit, she was found to be medically stable, but at home she moved very slowly, and difficulty in the initiating movement is observed by her daughter-in-law. Subjective is that, what is the subjective? Because we know we have to prepare a SOAP, that is subjective, objective assessment, and the treatment or the management. In the case of subjective, that there is a lady of 72-year-old woman who was diagnosed with a mild cognitive impairment 6 months ago, and was confusion is obtained for about 1 year before the diagnosis. Objectives, what was done was the serum chemistries and CBC was in the normal, but her MMC score was 21 out of 30. On the physical examination, she demonstrated the mild cog wheeling rigidity bilaterally and bradykinesia and the masked facies. So according to subjective and objective, what will be the assessment is that because of the physical health, unable to live by herself because she needs daily assistance for her daily task performance because of impaired cognition MM score level. So she needs a criteria, she meets the criteria for the dementia. So her rigidity, bradykinesia and masked facies are basically because of the Parkinson's disease, means along with the dementia, there's basically a Parkinson's disease. So she exhibits all the central features, that is all the central features, that is two core features and the one supportive features. And her presentation is because of the probable DLB versus PDD, mean there is basically a comparison between the Lewy body dementia and the Parkinson's disease dementia, and because of her temporal sequence and the lack of well-established diagnosis of the Parkinson's disease, so it indicates there is basically a dementia because of the Lewy body. The treatment is, first drug of choice is the cholinesterase inhibitor, because of are the only treatment for both the case of LBD and the case of PDD. Then we have the rivastigmin, means rivastigmin versus the tremor, and the 10% of the patient with the PDD, the levodopa carbidopa therapy should be started in order to cure the symptoms of the Parkinsonisms. And these are the references, that is book Cora Kimball and Applied Therapeutics, that is the clinical use of drugs, and the from the Google I have taken from the some of the material. Thank you from our side. अल्लाह हाफिज़।